What's going on, guys? It's me, Kazuchi. I know I haven't been on the channel much recently, but I'll try and make sure that I get in every so often. So today I came across something that is kind of baffling to me, and I thought that this is just way too ridiculous to be left unattended. And if you can read the title, you have seen probably that this is about the recent structure change in tournaments regarding the time and end of round rulings. Now, originally the rulings were that in a tournament, if you ended up going over the time limit of the round, then time would be called, and you and your opponent would have two turns apiece, 0, 1, 2, and 3, the counting, to play through your deck, starting at the person who is currently playing being at 0, and ending, of course, with the other player being at 3. At the end of those four rounds, the winner would be decided by who had the least amount of damage, and they would move on to the next round. However, during a recent qualifier, it's the Atlanta qualifier, if I am guessing correctly, the thing is, they implemented this rule halfway through the tournament, like, starting. So just imagine you enter a tournament with whatever deck, and you sit down, you get your pairings, the judge tells you how long it's going to be, whatever, and you sit down and you prepare yourself to you know, play against your opponent, and guess what? Rulings changed. Doesn't seem very professional, does it? The ruling itself is even more ridiculous. The end of round time ruling that I mentioned beforehand was actually, it changed there over to a ruling that both players would get a double loss. What a double loss means is that if you get a double loss, it's like you've lost to someone else who's lost to someone else who's lost. So basically, it's like a minus two to your points, I guess. It's really hard to understand, I know, but just basically it completely ruins your tiebreakers and ruins any chance you had of topping, and you're just out, you're done. Why is this problematic, you might say? Like, I hardly go to time, and I play Dark Irregulars. And the reason why this is problematic is because it cuts out most of the high-tier metagame decks. For instance, Angel Feather, anything to do with Kagero that isn't Overlord related, and anything Gold Paladin, anything Aqua Force, it is just absolutely ridiculous. Because of the fact that those ones are more focused on control and maintaining board presence, along with maintaining resource as much as possible, being consistent. And what's good about those decks is that it's a fail, like you're never gonna go wrong with those ones. You're always gonna have a decent board presence, at least with Gold Paladin and Aqua Force. With Angel Feather, you're always gonna have a decent hand size or a good hand, and with Kagero, you're never gonna have to worry about your opponent's attacks. However, they completely cut out these three major clans completely out of this because of the fact that they implemented this new rule, pushing on the aggro play that is so pushed even now with G units coming out and different things like that. Specifically for Gear Chronicles, that's the reason why people speculate that Gear Chronicles won so much, and so often in that tournament, and I would agree with this. I myself am a Anub of Tama player, so which is a rather niche deck, I know, or a rather niche clan, in fact. But Anub of Tama is a rather... It's an aggro control, if that is even a viable thing to say, where it's based on taking cards out of your opponent's hand and using the abusing the after image effect to bounce your own cards that are on the field back to your hand, so you have hand advantage while also being able to deplete your opponent's hand. So that's the entirety of it. Just focus on pushing for more attacks. I play one that's mainly based around Otagalord, which, if your opponent has three or less cards in hand, gains an extra critical. Amazing card. It's usually an end game. That's your win con. If I was to enter this tournament, I wouldn't be affected. However, I know a lot of people who do play control decks and who do enjoy Angel Feather. I know I've planned on building Angel Feather in the past, but never end up doing it. Purely because of the fact that it didn't fit my playstyle. I was more of an aggressive player, but I do see where these people are coming from. And simply cutting out half your metagame just to make way for Gear Chronicle, the clan we all know that you're trying to push, the hardest pushy, you gotta stop with this, okay? Making rulings simply to push what you think that people should be playing, because Gear Chronicles is a major failure in the beginning, with it just being too slow. You could stay on two, and all of a sudden your opponent, whoever's playing Gear Chronicle, would not be able to keep up because they don't have good grade 2 aggro, would immediately lose. And they fixed that, thank God. But now the only things that you're going to see topping there... I know I saw that Great Nature topped. I know I saw that. We saw that here. I'll actually pull up the top eight for Atlanta were 3 Mega Colony, 2 Gear Chronicle, 1 Angel Feather. Funny enough, that was one of the ones that topped that I mentioned beforehand. So good for you, whoever it was. 1 Great Nature of the Big Belly build. And 1 Link Joker, Messiah, of course. Now, why this is worrying to me is the fact that anything that focuses on aggro or shutting down your opponent entirely, anything locking, lockdown or aggro will instantly win in this scene. Because if two people who are playing control decks happen to face each other, have fun getting past that without actually triple critting the person at the end of the game. But yeah, this is just gotta stop. This is absolutely insane. One of the scariest things that they've ever implemented. implemented ever since the idea of making it illegal to not play a grade two on, or sorry, play a grade three on your turn, because it would be stalling the game, despite the fact that it's clearly not. But thank God that was never passed. This has to be one of the single worst ideas that Bushi has ever made, and let alone the worst times to do it to a crowd of people who had no idea, who went there simply because of the fact that they want to enter a large scale tournament, something that I'm very aware of and I love doing. I have yet to enter a regionals, and the idea of a large scale tournament would be, for instance, when I visited Toronto, and I entered a locals there. There were at least 35 to 40 people. Shout out to ANC for you guys. That was extremely interesting, and it was actually more energetic. The atmosphere there was more energetic, and it was just, I can't even imagine with hundreds of people how that would happen. The petition I mentioned is down in the description there. It goes over a various different things. I'm not going to cover them this because, honestly, this has been going on way too long. But as an introduction, talking about the time and end of round rulings, the best of one versus best of three ruling, going back to what it was, back in the day where it was, a best of three format, and, top cut and invitation, elimination, media coverage, shop qualifiers, regional qualifiers, national qualifiers, and world qualifiers. Should that become a thing. In the end, guys, there's a lot that Bushi needs to change, especially when it comes to ruling. That doesn't seem to be their forte. But, you know what? Just sign the petition, get it out there, get it around, and push back against this. We don't need to deal with this BS ruling. So, anyway, I'm Ikazuchi. I'll sign off. Later.